So you've decided that you want to go into a Bachelor of Science degree at DigiPen, but we've got a lot of different ones, and so there could be some question about which one you really want to go into. But the first thing to realize is that for any Bachelor of Science degree at DigiPen, there's a lot of commonality between them. They're all focused on technology, and so there's a common core that goes through all of them. The core starts with computer science. You're going to learn C and C++ in any of these degrees. You're going to learn data structures. You're going to learn algorithms. You're going to become a computer scientist no matter which of these degrees you take. Even ones like the computer engineering that don't have that in the name, or BSCSD, these are still computer science. You learn how to code. You also, of course, get a lot of mathematics, because to be a really skilled computer scientist, you have to have mathematics at a level that a lot of other areas do not require. You're gonna have to learn linear algebra, you're gonna have to learn calculus, you're gonna have to learn a lot deeper mathematics than sometimes people expect for this, because to be a skilled programmer, someone who can implement complicated algorithms, you must have that mathematical background. You're also gonna need science, in particular, physics. This is because a lot of what we're doing, whether it's in games, whether it's building computer hardware, or whether it's actually dealing with audio, you must have a real background in physics in order to program this stuff well. And of course, there's also common to all the degrees is general education. So the skills from English to communications to social sciences and humanities, you're gonna have to have some of those as well just to be a well-rounded employee and well-rounded individual once you go out into the professional working world. In addition to the Common Core, if you go into the Bachelor of Science in Computer Science and Real-Time Interactive Simulation, you'll actually learn how to build game engines from scratch. You'll do it in C++, building 2D and 3D game engines. This is really difficult because we're not talking about using the engines that are already out there in the industry, the ones that most people use to build games. We're talking about building them from the ground up, building the physics, building the graphics, the artificial intelligence, and the networking for the entire game. This takes a lot of time to master. It requires advanced mathematics. It requires things like curves and surfaces, quaternions, things that often aren't even taught to most undergraduates. But if you want to build real-time interactive simulations, you've got to learn how to do that. It's not going to be easy to actually master this, but if you can go through this and learn how to build 3D physics, 3D graphics in real time, including shaders, lighting, shadows, all the advanced graphic techniques that are out there, and learn how to do behaviors, artificial intelligence, how everything behaves in a game, not just simple scripted events, but complex behaviors that verge on artificial intelligence, and the networking, keeping the latency really low in a real-time environment. That's all very difficult, but if you manage to pull off, if you can get through it, you'll be an elite programmer. You'll be someone who has done all of this difficult programming and done it in a real-time environment where everything has to be done in 15 milliseconds. You're trying to go 60 frames a second, that's all you've got every frame. If you can do that, you can program any type of simulation, games or not, that the industry would ever want.